Netflix's biggest investment to date in a movie is finally here. Red Notice releases in theaters on November 5th and on Netflix on November 12th. I got a chance to watch it early. If you want to know how I watched it early, jump down in the description of the video where I have described in detail of how I get to watch all the movies in advance. And follow me on Instagram for all the movie updates and all my early reviews over there. So that's it. Let's jump on to the actual Red Notice review. Well, I won't say Red Notice was a disappointment. I had a hell of a great time with this film. It is such an entertaining film, but there's a but over here. It's not a great film. It's entertaining, just like a lot of other generic action movies. It's entertaining, but it's not a great film. It has horrible writing and weird plot elements in it. First of all, I will say that this is strictly an action movie and it does nothing new in the action genre. At this point, you've got so many action movies that they need to reinvent themselves rather than just showing the casual action scenes like a lot of movies now. See, John Wick is an action franchise, but it's so great to watch because it has some great new action scenes in it. Red Notice suffers from those same mistakes that a lot of other action movies make. They offer nothing new when it comes to their action sequences. It's just the simple kind of action scene, car chases here and there. But there's not a single moment in Red Notice where I went, "Whoa, that was amazing." There's nothing like that in this film. It's just simple action. I was having a lot of great time with it. It was nice to see, because action scenes are nice to see, and it does not really give us some great action scenes. I mean, they are just simple though action scenes. They are long, of course. There are long action scenes where some great things happen, but still, that's my biggest complaint. It feels nothing new. The plot, the writing in this film, I don't think it's done well. It was just mediocre. There's nothing great in the writing. In fact, there are several moments where I thought the writing was horrible. The performances, well, Ryan Reynolds is a charming guy. He is always great in a film. And even here, I think Ryan Reynolds gave the best performance, followed by Dwayne Johnson, who is also a bit of a charming guy. But Gal Gadot, well, sorry for her, because I think Gal Gadot is gorgeous and a scene stealer whenever she's on screen, but I still doubt her acting skills. I mean, of course she's great when it comes to fighting and action scenes, but when we have to just give the dialogues and those action scenes, I think her dialogue delivery in this film particularly, I think it's poor, really poor. I mean, I like her as Wonder Woman, she's great in that role, but I don't know about her roles outside of Wonder Woman. I just don't know what's the problem over there, but I just didn't like her in this film. She was good when it comes to action, but when it comes to actual acting skills, I think she was the worst of the three. Dwayne Johnson, well, he doesn't really suit in his role. The FBI agent he's playing, I think he's not, I mean, he's not that, you know, a lot of spy type of guy, so that's another thing, but I think his performance was at least good. Ryan Reynolds, as I said, is really great in every movie, and he's great in this one too, so I never have a problem with Ryan Reynolds, because he's always great. This movie is the biggest investment Netflix has ever made into a streaming movie. See, they have made big action movies before. They have made Extraction, they have made Six Underground, they have made The Old Guard, Triple Frontier, but I don't think any of those movies were absolutely amazing. Not even Extraction, which is the highest viewed movie on Netflix. Red Notice, I don't think was better. Can be called better than all of those? No, I don't think. I mean, Six Underground was easily the worst. Triple Frontier, The Old Guard, all those were mediocre. Extraction was also mediocre for me. I think in terms of entertainment, This one is the best out of them. But does it even feel like the biggest investment Netflix has ever made into a streaming movie? I would say the visual effects in this film, I don't think they're really good. There's a particular sequence where I really thought the visual effects could have been way better. It looked so unrealistic. And that's a minor problem I had with this film. Overall, it's one hell of an entertaining ride. The plot is great. However, there are some elements in the plot that feel really weird and really useless and all. So I think it was great. It's funny. It's a funny film, sure. So I would like to give this one an overall 6.2 out of 10. You should surely check it out. It might be a hell of an amazing time for you. And if you are really, and if you really are a critic, you can just find all the bad elements in it too. So that was my review for Red Notice. Like, share, and subscribe Film Villa, and do not forget to follow me on Instagram, Film Villa Movie Updates.